Does Venus have a moon?
Check the Wikipedia and you'll know.
Although hundreds of natural satellites have been discovered in the solar system, Venus, the second planet from the Sun, does not have any moons. Mercury, the planet closest to the Sun, also lacks moons. However, in 2002, astronomers discovered the first quasi-moon around Venus. A quasi-moon can be understood as something that looks like a satellite at first glance but is not in the same category. This unusual celestial body was initially named 2002 VE68. By February 2024, it was given a more lively and cute name, Zuvi. This quasi-moon orbits Venus but is hardly influenced by its gravity, instead following a complex path around both Venus and the Sun. Its orbit is highly unstable, meaning there's a high chance that it will eventually be ejected. Strictly speaking, it cannot be considered a moon of Venus, but it can be seen as a temporary, partially adopted, kidnapped, or imprisoned part-time satellite. Such quasi-moons were predicted earlier but were only observed starting in 2002. Since then, Earth's quasi-moons have also been discovered. 2002 VE68 was the 1,705th asteroid discovered in the first half of November 2002, with a diameter of only 230 meters. Its orbit crosses Earth's, so it is also considered one of the thousands of near-Earth asteroids. It passes within a few million kilometers of Earth every 8 years or so, posing some scare but virtually no risk of collision. The name Zuvi is uncommon for planetary bodies. Typically, astronomers who approve celestial names prefer literary references for objects.
Then why was such a strange name chosen?
Was it chosen randomly?
Yes, it was chosen randomly. Or to be more accurately, there is actually a funny story behind that, but that's not today's theme. Most cataloged quasi-moons belong to Earth. By 2024, the Earth is known to have 7 quasi-moons. But you might still be confused. So, how are satellites and quasi-moons defined? The simplest way to distinguish them is by observing their trajectories. The moon's path around Earth is a smooth elliptical orbit, while its path around the Sun is more complex, resembling a swinging spiral curve. In contrast, a quasi-moon follows a very smooth elliptical orbit around the Sun simultaneously. Its orbit is so closely synchronized with the planets that it appears to be orbiting the planet. Look, the green line represents Venus's orbit. Looking at the gray part, 2002 VE68's orbit is a perfect ellipse around the Sun. However, from Venus's perspective, the region swept by this asteroid looks like a lentil. This is all due to gravity. While the Sun plays the primary role, it is inevitably influenced by Venus's pull and push, leading it into a resonant orbit with the planet. Fundamentally, despite their different orbital shapes, their periods around the Sun are almost identical. As a result, this asteroid appears to orbit both the Sun and Venus simultaneously. However, these quasi-moons of Venus and Earth will not remain stable for long. A 2004 study suggested that 2002 VE68 could only maintain its status as Venus's quasi-moon for about 7,000 years. Before that, it might have been just a near-Earth asteroid, pushed to its current position by Earth's gravity. After orbiting the Sun for several thousand more cycles, it could be ejected due to chaotic interactions among the Sun, Venus, Earth, and Mercury. This is an n-body problem. Calculating the orbits of two interacting bodies is straightforward, but adding another makes it a chaotic system without precise solutions. Ultimately, whether it will be captured by Venus as an official satellite, plunge into the Sun, crash into the Pacific Ocean, destroy a Category 5 hurricane, or be ejected to Proxima Centauri is uncertain. In reality, we cannot predict its future path. But for now, we know that it is with Venus and probably will continue to orbit the Sun once more with this bright and lonely planet. Speaking of the solar system, do you know about Planet 9? See here.